Wash your hands. Wipe your bench.
Before you use the pipette for the first time, you should practice a bit without a tip or liquids just to get a feel for the instrument. Press gently down on the plunger. You should feel it come to a stop. This is called the first stop. If you press down harder on the plunger, you will feel that it can go down even further, all the way down, which is called the second stop. The first and second stops serve different purposes. To release the plunger, do not simply remove your thumb or finger from it. Instead, guide the plunger upward so that it does not snap up. You should practice stopping at the first stop, releasing the plunger by guiding it back up, and then pressing down to the first stop and the second stop. Try this several times until you are proficient in the use of the plunger. Once you have mastered the depression and release of the plunger, you can try to pipette some imaginary liquids in the air. I will demonstrate how to use the pipette. It is smart to try this along with me. Set the pipette to 90 microliters. Attach an imaginary tip to the pipette and hold the pipette up in the air. Press down on the plunger until you reach the first stop and hold it there. Stick the imaginary tip into your imaginary liquid. You only put the tippy end of the tip in the liquid. If you put the tip in too deep, you risk getting water near the top of the tip, which can damage the pipette. Now gently guide the plunger upward, releasing it. The action of the pipette will suck exactly 90 microliters of your imaginary liquid into the tip. Normally, you would look at the tip to visually verify that the liquid is in there. Now move the pipette over to a new imaginary container where you will deposit the imaginary liquid. It is a good idea to touch the tip to the inside wall of the container and hold the pipette at a slight angle. Now press the plunger down to the first stop and all the way to the second stop. This will deposit the imaginary liquid into the imaginary container.